Hi, this is Elena from the Kepler.io team. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how to synchronize your Airtable data with Google Sheets in a few clicks. I'll also guide you through the basic settings and capabilities our add-in offers. If you don't have the tool installed yet, you can do so on G Suite Marketplace. The download link is in the description of this video. To start importing your data, navigate to Add-ins, choose Kepler.io, and open the dashboard. When you use the add-in for the first time, you have no data sources connected to it yet, so we'll start by adding a new importer. Hit the Add Importer button, find Airtable on the list of available data sources, and select it. The settings window pops up. Let's give this importer a title. I want to import data from my Airtable base for tracking sandwich orders in San Francisco, so I'll name it Airtable San Francisco Sandwiches. Let me name the sheet Orders. The next step is the key element of our setup. To import an Airtable view to a Google Sheet, we need to add a shared link for this view into this field. For that, I'm going to navigate to my Airtable, create a shared link for the view I'm going to import, copy this link, and paste it right here. I need this data to be constantly up to date in this spreadsheet, and I want it to sync up with Airtable on an hourly basis. So I will leave the automatic data refresh toggle on and pick 1 hour frequency. If your Airtable view is password protected, you need to enter it in the additional settings. My view has unrestricted access, so I'm leaving this field blank. Let's move on to the settings. Choose a data import mode. Pick Replace if on each data re-import you want to fully rewrite the data you have in the spreadsheet with the latest information from Airtable, or Append to place new entries from Airtable below the data that was previously added to your spreadsheet. The first scenario works better for me, so I'm going to pick the Replace mode. The next field lets you choose the cell address you want your data to be imported to. By default, it's A1. But if, let's say, you have a few number columns in Airtable and want to add a sum formula in the sheet, you can change A1 to B1, for example, and the first column will remain blank after the data import. I don't necessarily need it, so I will leave A1 here. The last updated setting adds the column to the left of your actual data and displays the date and time when each row was last updated. This is not crucial for me, so I'm going to leave it to the default No option. Now that we have all the setup fields filled out, let's hit Add Importer. The add-in is processing all the settings now and creating a new importer for me. Okay, as you can see, the importer has been added, and a new sheet with the name I picked earlier has been created. Now let's run it to sync the data. I'm doing a manual import now, but in the future, the data will be updated automatically according to my settings. Here we go! As you can see, my Airtable data has been added to the sheet. Looks good! Since I've set the auto-import setting to 1 hour frequency, the sheet will be updated in an hour automatically with the latest values from Airtable. The three dots to the right of the importer's name give you the following handy options. Edit to make any necessary changes to the importer's setup. Run to manually update data, toggle details to see the full list of settings of the importer, and help to look up the instructions in using the add-in in the knowledge base. That's it for setting up an Airtable importer in Kepler.io. Hope you found this video helpful. For any questions, you're welcome to reach our support team and we will happily assist you.